If you have a Mac and want to spruce up your Zoom calls, and you also own a Sony camera, do I have news for you?
Sony has just released Imaging Edge Webcam for the Mac. It's an app that allows you to plug your Sony camera into your computer and use it as a webcam. I'm going to walk you through how to set everything up on your camera and your Mac, because there are a few steps. First, I want to mention that sadly, it doesn't seem to work with FaceTime. Apple's support page says you can use external webcams for FaceTime, but it didn't show up as an option when I tried it. But it works great in Zoom. The list of supported cameras is pretty big, even going back to some of the older models like the A7 II from 2014. One of the more popular cameras that it doesn't support is the A6000, which I'm guessing is a hardware limitation of that camera. As far as Macs go, I have a pretty modest one. It's a 2013 MacBook Air with 4 GB of RAM. So if this thing can handle it, I'm sure you'll have no problems. This app supports macOS 10.13 High Sierra, 10.14 Mojave, and 10.15 Catalina, which is the one I'm using. If anybody is beta testing Big Sur and tries this out, leave me a comment and let me know how it works for you. Now, let's look at how quick and easy it is to install. Before you plug your camera in, you'll want to go into your camera settings to check a few things. First, go to the Network 1 tab, which looks like a globe. Go to Control with Smartphone and make sure that's set to off. Your camera might not have this, and if it doesn't, then you can move on to the next step. The next setting is under Setup 4, which looks like a briefcase for some reason. Make sure USB power supply is set to on, so your computer can supply power to your camera. Next, on the same page, go to USB connection and set it to PC remote. If you have one of the very newest cameras like the A7C, A7R 4, A9 Mark II, A7S Mark III, or the ZV-1, the USB connection setting is located under the Network tab instead. And that's it, your camera is ready to go, it's time to set up your Mac. I'll put a link in the description to Sony's site where you can download the app for your Mac. It's a tiny download, just about 10 megabytes. It's an easy installer, you just check the box of the camera you own, click the link to download it, and then open the file to go through the prompts. Once you install it and restart your computer, plug your Sony camera into one of the USB ports on your Mac. I'm using a USB-C to USB-A cable, and it works perfectly. Now we can hop into the Zoom settings by clicking the Zoom menu in the top left corner, then choosing Preferences. Click the Video tab on the left, and under the Camera dropdown, select Sony Camera Imaging Edge. Turn your camera on, and everything should come to life. I think the quality looks great, and your friends and colleagues on Zoom are going to think you look great. The frame rate isn't super smooth. It looks like it's a little lower than 24, but it looks good enough to me. The resolution is 1024 by 576, which sounds a little low on paper, but it still looks great. It looks way better than like a 720p or even 1080p webcam.
Because we all know how great webcams are.
The other important thing to note is that it doesn't use the audio feed from the camera itself, so you'll have to plug in a separate mic into your computer or use the built-in laptop mic. I've been using my AirPods and there's been no issues there. If your camera supports it, like the A7 III, your Mac can charge the camera somewhat while you're using it. On most Sony cameras, the USB port won't deliver quite enough power to keep it topped off, but it drastically reduces battery drain. It shouldn't be a problem unless you're using it for hours on end, and I think for most people it'll be fine. I tested it out and had it running for about 2 hours, and the battery was still at about 75%. So even if you're using it for a 2-3 hour class, it'll have enough battery to make it all the way through. If you need it for a stream that's longer than that, there are AC adapters that you can plug into the battery port. I'm so happy we're finally getting Sony webcam support on the Mac. I wish we could use it for FaceTime because that's what I use personally, but for my Zoom calls for classes and things like that, it works great. With everybody using Zoom these days, it's a great way to improve the quality and show off a little bit. If you have a PC, I also took a look at the Windows version of this app back when it came out. And if you want to catch my content every single week, make sure to subscribe.